Here's another seafood recipe. Since our country is an island, we get so creative with seafood, and it takes up a major part in our cuisine. This delectable dish will go with any Sri Lankan mains. This is my grandmother's recipe, passed on to us for generations. We've been trying to preserve the original recipe, so I have a lot of tips for you which I would tell along the way. This requires only a few ingredients and is very easy to make, yet you'll be astonished by the end results. Let's have a look at how to make the Jaffna style prawn curry. Follow the exact measurement and don't substitute anything. Heat the coconut oil. I'm using just 1 teaspoon, that should be enough. Add the onion. And garlic. Don't reduce the amount of garlic because this would really give a rich flavor to the curry. And prawns always go well with garlic. If some of the garlic cloves are big, you can cut those vertically. Once it's done cooking, it'll be very nice to mix with the rest of the curry and eat. Add the fenugreek seeds. It's cooling to the body and it aids digestion as well. It gives a nice flavor to the curry, but don't add too much because the gravy would become bitter. Stir well for a couple of minutes until the onions start turning brown. Add the prawns. Give everything a good stir. After about 2 minutes, add some salt. I'm adding a bit more because we are going to be adding tamarind as well. Stir well. Add the Jaffna curry powder. This is not to be mistaken for the normal chili powder. This curry does require the Jaffna curry powder. Mix well and keep stirring for a couple of minutes. Add the tamarind paste. Don't replace it with lime, lemon, vinegar, tomato or even goraka. This really requires tamarind paste. If you don't have the paste and if you are using the normal tamarind mixed with water, then keep in mind that the taste actually shouldn't be dominating the gravy. The tamarind taste should be there, but you shouldn't feel the presence too much, so add accordingly. Add the thick coconut milk. Mix well and let it cook for a couple of minutes. Add the curry leaves. Oops, one leaf didn't want to leave my hand. Stir well. Let it boil in medium flame. As the gravy thickens, the color would get darkened as well. It has been about 10 to 15 minutes. I'm still not satisfied with the consistency, so I'm gonna leave it for another 5 minutes. This is the exact color and consistency that this should be in. You can have this with pittu, string hoppers, hoppers, roti, rice and curry, bread, and the best is yellow rice. I'll link the recipe to my yellow rice in this video. Do try and let me know how it turns out. If you are new to this channel, please don't forget to like and subscribe.